Okay, is it visible?
Yes.
Yes, it is visible.
Okay, good afternoon, everyone. I'm Arun D'Souza, working with Shin'etsu Chemicals as a technical sales manager for the last 7 years. So in the next 20 minutes, I'll take you quickly through the introduction to the solid dispersion. You let me know if there is any lag time in the slides. So the agenda for today's presentation is, I'm on the agenda slide. So why you need a solid dispersion? What are these solid dispersion approaches? Shin'etsu A-code, the generic name is HPMC acetate succinate. What is structure, chemistry and grades? First commercial product using cellulosic polymers. One thing to keep in mind here is my presentation is mainly related to cellulosic polymers, because we are mainly into the cellulosic business. And one technique, that is co-precipitation. What is the commercial product and process available? Okay, and what are the commercial products using HPMC acetate succinate? So you are aware about the BCS classification. These are four quadrants, class one. On the x-axis, you can see the solubility, marked as the solubility from low to high, and y-axis like a permeability from low to high. So the drugs which are having a high solubility, like class 1 and class 3, is not difficult to formulate. And many of the companies, many of pharmaceutical industry have done with this class 1 and class 3 molecules. And mostly, most of the companies are working in class 2 and class 4 molecules. So the challenge here is to improve the solubility, because the solubility is low in this class 2 and class 4 molecules. On the left hand side, I have mentioned few of the methods, physical methods and chemical methods for improving the solubility of API. So what is solid dispersion? So if I tell you in simple words, it is a molecular dispersion of polymer and API to bring the solubility improvement. So here I have given a pictorial, like just to understand, to make the point. When we do a physical mixture, this is representing a drug and this is like a polymer, they remain in the original form. So they don't increase the solubility of your dosage form. But in case if you are doing a solid dispersion by any method, there are various methods of any of the method, basically you are trying to put this API into a polymer matrix. That's how you get a solubility enhancement. If you see graphically, so this shows, this dotted line shows the crystalline solubility and the red line shows the physical mixtures, because in both the cases, API is still in the crystalline form. So there is no solubility or very minimum. And if you see, when you do a solid dispersion technique, a manifold solubility in the solid dispersion. So there are various processes. So as far as cellulosic polymers are concerned, I will broadly classify it into a solvent method and a solvent free method, or a hot melt extrusion method, or sometimes we say as an HME method, hot melt extrusion. So this machine part and the process related part is covered in a separate topic after me. So I will not talk upon this topic of hot melt extrusion. Under solvent methods, again, it is briefly divided again into three categories. One is like a spray drying, top spray granulation or a spray coating, and a co-precipitation. Again, these topics of solvent method are covered by one of my colleagues in a separate presentation. So I will talk only about this co-precipitation approach in the subsequent slides. So the starting material, as you can see in the solvent method, is you are dissolving API and polymer in a common solvent. And based on the setup, what is available at the customer's end or a company end, they decide, or there are some other characteristics also, which method you can go with. So now when you know what is the challenges, what is the processes you can go with for a cellulosic polymer, how will you choose it? If you have an API, for example, with you for development, and you are told to do a solid dispersion for cellulosic polymer. So how do you choose which method to go, whether to go for a solvent method or a solvent-free or a HMA method? So I hope I'm on a process choice slide. Or is there a still lag time in a slide?
Yeah,
there is.
I have experience in solid dispersion process slides.
We are in still solid dispersion.
Yeah. So I hope there is a lag.
I think you can stop sharing and again you start.
Hello.
Yes, sir.
Nilesh, can you see the process choice slide?
Not yet. No, actually we are not able to see any slides.
Just stop sharing and I'll again reconnect.
Yeah.
Is the slide visible?
No.
No, it is not.
Mr. Arun, shall I try from my side?
Yeah, please. If you have, you can just open the presentation from your side if you can.
Is it visible?
No, I think.
Yeah, it is visible now. It is visible?
Yes. Yes.
Yeah. Can you put it in the presentation mode, Mayuresh?
Yeah.
Okay. So this. So I have a restriction now. I cannot put a pointer to this, what I'm talking. But I hope you will understand. Here it is showing on the x-axis your solid melting point of API. The pink portion is like a below 200 degree, and what is in yellow portion like a challenging is above 200 degree centigrade, which is more challenging to formulate or to convert into a amorphous form. On the left hand side, you can see the y-axis is like a organic solubility in organic solvents. So from a low to high. So when you have a melting point of API less, you can always go below 200, you can always use a hot melt extrusion. And if you have a very high solubility in organic solvent, you can always try with the organic solvent. So there you get a choice whether you want to use hot melt extrusion or a solvent method. So based on the equipments or your feasibility at your end, you can select solvent method or hot melt extrusion method. And the challenging one is what I will be talking about in the subsequent slides of a co-precipitation approach. Okay, the next slide is like a process for solid dispersion. So if you see this process, this is a graphical representation given. The SD stands for the spray drying and HME. This is the marketed products in the last 10 to 15 years. Okay, so majority of the marketed products are with spray drying or with hot melt extrusion. There are very few with the top spray granulation or co-precipitation or a fluid bed layering approach. Mayuresh, please go to the next one. So in the next slides, see, you can see this. These are the APIs or the actual products into the market. And on the left-hand side is the column for the polymers. So what are the polymers they have used? And what is the trade name? Trade name is the brand name of a particular company. And actives is, next column is actives, is the API name. And the right-hand side will be the manufacturing method, like what method or what solid dispersion technique they have adopted to develop that particular drug. So in all, if you see the list on the left-hand side, there is only one product with polyethylene glycol. There are four products with HPMC, and there are 11 products with HPMC AS, that is HPMC acetate succinate, and 8 products with PVPA. So this is the list we have taken from an external article from the Journal of Pharmaceutical Sciences. Mayuresh, please change the slide.
Yeah.
So in the next slide, you can see, we have seen in the previous slide, there are around 11 products which are developed with HPMC acetate succinate. So till date, it is the highest using any polymer. So what is HPMC acetate succinate, or we call it Shinetsu Eikut? So we are the Shinetsu is the innovator for this products. So this product was launched in 1985 as an entry coating polymer. So this is in short the process or a manufacturing process, I would say. So initially you need to manufacture HPMC. So that has a hydroxy propyl methyl groups. And then further you are doing a reaction, you're substituting HPMC with either acetyl content or a succinyl content. That becomes an HPMC acetate succinate. Or if you do substitute with the phthalic acid, it becomes HPMC phthalate. So the middle portion is HPMC phthalate and the right hand side is the HPMC acetate succinate. Please change the slide, Mahesh.
Yeah.
Okay, this next slide is giving you the Shinetsu Eikut structure. So in a structure, these are like n number of monomers in the glucose unit chain. Wherever you can see this R, those R can be substituted with either hydrogen atom, methyl, acetyl and succinyl contains. So this on this chain, the R will be substituted with these functional groups. So you have a acetate succinate item. So this slide is giving you all the acetate succinate grades. So there are in all 9 grades where Shinetsu is promoting. On the left, on the tabular form, you can see these are 6 grades, AS, LF, AS, LG, AS, MF. So that AS stands for the acetate succinate. L stands for the low pH because it is a pH dependent polymer. So it has a L stands for the pH solubility of 5.5 and above. So the pH solubility column is given on the extreme right. M stands for the middle, that is pH 6. H stands for the high pH, that is above 6.5 pH. So based on the particle size, these grades are further classified into 3 parts. F stands for the fine grade, G for the granular, and down what is mentioned in a small tabular form, AS, LMP, MMP, and HMP. These are the medium particle size. So these 3 distinguished particle size, either in the shape, size, or the functional groups, like a methoxy, hydroxy, acetyl, and succinyl content. So the fine grades we were promoting for the aqueous coating, it forms an aqueous dispersion, granular grades for the solvent coating, and LMP, MMP is mainly for the hot melt extrusion. Where is change this slide, please?
Yeah.
So the next slide is giving you the statistics of academic publication using HPMC acetate succinate. To start with, the pink line on the extreme right is like when the product was launched in 1985. So there were a few articles on the stock studies. Then subsequent almost 10-15 years will be mainly on other formulation or coating. These publications, but if you see from 2008 onwards, like you can see the many red blocks. The red blocks stands for the solid dispersion. So these are the academic publication where they also academics also publicizing those papers on the solid dispersion. So they also go hand in hand with the industry. In the previous slides, I had shown you from 2007. There were so many products which were using a solid dispersion approach. So why you should use HPMC AS? So the next slide is giving you the reasons. And these are the reasons we have taken it from an external article also. You have the reference below. They have studied almost 41 grades in this particular articles. Maybe not that many polymers. Polymers could be 10, 15, but there were different grades of every polymer. Every polymer has 4, 5, 6 grades. So they have studied around 41 grades in this article, and they have concluded that HPMC acetate succinate, it increases the solubility, and at the same time, it maintains this supersaturation for a longer period of time as compared to the cellulose acetate phthalate, normal HPMC, HPMC phthalate, PVP or methacrylic, this kind of polymers. Mayrish, please go to the next.
Yeah, it's just taking some time.
So the next slide is giving you the reason, like one of the reason why it is improving your solubility or it maintains a super saturation. You can see in the graph, these are the equilibrium moisture content of those polymers, plain polymers. And the lowest down the line, like a reddish or a yellowish graph, it is of the HPMC acetate, succinate and phthalate. So it has got a less moisture content. So this is one of the reason it increases as well as it maintains the super saturation over a period of time. And in those this block, you can see the at 93% humidity for 30 days period, there is a comparison of acetate succinate, VA64 and Soluplus. So among these also you can make out visibly also acetate succinate is mostly stable as compared to the other polymers. So what are the characteristics for solid dispersion? So HPMC acetate succinate has 3 chemical grades and almost 9 grades which are differing in the particle size and chemically as well. It hydrogen bonding and hydrophobic interaction is there in this particular acetate succinate, so it maintains super amorphous as well as super saturation. Low moisture content, commercial, there is not just the theoretical part what we are just promoting, this is commercially. In almost all the techniques, there are products available in the market, mainly in the US market. And this was originally launched as an entry coating agent, where you could do an entry coating for a gastric resistant drugs in a non-aqueous form, aqueous form, dry entry form, or some neutralization approaches, as we have seen in some duloxetine molecule. So this slide is giving you all a picture of those products which were first launched using cellulosic polymer. Now we have seen the publication or the commercial product from 2007 onwards. But if you see the soluble dispersion history using cellulosics, in 1979, Merck has launched Sipamid capsules, and they had used a plain HPMC. And what grade from Shinetsu was used is Pharmacode 603 grade, which is having a 3 VCPs viscosity. In 1986, they brought an extended release product of this using HPMC phthalate. And in 1994, the first solid dispersion product using HPMC acetate succinate was launched by Syria Pharmaceuticals. So what is a pharmacode? What was the function of pharmacode? What was used in Sipamid capsules? So we have a pharmacode which differs in 4 different grades. The viscosity ranges from 3 to 15 CPs. Mainly this is used for film coating of tablets or a binder for wet granulation. Capsule companies are also using to make a hard capsules. Like we say, the wedge capsules using this low viscosity HPMC. And we have also noticed in the extended release form of cipamate capsules, they have used the HPMC phthalate. So that is also been provided by Shinetsu. So we have three different grades in HPMC phthalate: HP50, HP55, and HP55S. They differ either in the soluble pH range, like each grade has a different solubility, like above pH 5.5, above 5, like that. And they differ in the viscosity as well as the phthalyl content in the grades. So originally, this polymer was launched for entry coating application. Here, the trick is you have to use either hydroalcoholic system or a complete organic system. Here, you cannot use water or there is a hydrolysis of phthalic group in this. So we always recommended to use ethanol water like 80-20 ratio or a complete organic system for entry coating. So this is the picture of the cipamate or nifedipine capsules. The nifedipine is the drug, cipamate is the brand name. And this is in short the process what they have done. So they have basically dissolved pharmacode along with API and in a common solvent, and then they have sprayed it on the lactose. So they have also tried using other polymers, and the results I will share it, I'll show it in the next slide. So here you can see in the first graph A, they have also tried with PVP. PVP increased the solubility but could not maintain the supersaturation on stability for 5 weeks. B is the pharmacode 603. It increases the solubility and it maintains for a continuous 5 week period. MC is for the methyl cellulose, which is graph C, using SM15. It increased the solubility, it maintained as well. But if you compare with pharmacode, it is less. And without the polymer, that is a plain API, you can see there is very little solubility. So the here API to polymer ratio in this cipamate or a nifedipine capsule was 1:3. One part of API and three parts of polymer. And this is the cipamate R, that is an extended release form. And here also the API to polymer ratio, what they have taken is 1:3 in this. And now the Landel. Landel is the first solid dispersion using HPMC acetate succinate. So the Landel is the brand name, and the API is ifenodipine hydrochloride. It was developed by Nissan Chemical and Zyria Pharmaceuticals. It was approved in 1994 in Japan, and this was formulated by top spray granulation approach. So now I'll be talking about a few slides I'll be sharing about the co-precipitation approach. So my colleagues will be talking about hot melt extrusion technology. Another colleague will be talking about the solvent approach, that is spray drying and top spray granulation. So which is not talked upon is a co-precipitation. So based on this article, I'll share you. This is a commercial product, Zelborof, by Roche. They have done it with the co-precipitation approach. Basically, it is for the treatment of melanoma, and the API is vemurafenib. So if you can recollect just 10 minutes back what I said, there was a four quadrants, and one quadrant was a challenging yellowish color. So because it has got a very high melting point, that is above 200 degrees centigrade, here you can see it has vemurafenib has 272.1 degrees centigrade. If you check the solubility in aqueous, there is no solubility. In organic also, apart from dimethyl sulfoxide, that is DMSO, In the common organic solvent, there is very little solubility. So that is the main reason why the company has gone with the co-precipitation approach. So the process here is given in short. So they have initially scrutinized ionic polymers like HPMC acetate succinate, HPMC phthalate. Eudragide is like a methacrylic acid. These are the ionic polymers which they studied, and API. So what they have done, they have dissolved in a common solvent, and the drug to polymer ratio is 40:60. And the solvent what they have taken is DME, that is dimethyl acetamide, and the solid concentration or the amount of drug in a per 100 ml of solution is 15%. And in control condition, they have precipitated. So they have added 0.01 normal HCl at 2 to 5 degrees centigrade, and then they have further washed those precipitate. And what you are getting those powder, they call it as MBP, that is micro precipitated bulk powder. Yeah, can you go to the next slide, please, Mahendresh? Yeah, so this slide is giving you a graph of this results of this MBP, that is micro precipitated bulk powder. You can see here with the Eudragide, it is having a less solubility as compared with the HPMC AS. ASLF is the grade what is used for this in this vemurafenib drug. So with HPMC acetate succinate, they got a manifold solubility as compared to the other ionic polymers. And if you see on the right hand side, that is a pH dependent release. So since this is an pH dependent ASLF, it gives a solubility above pH 5.5. It has given a double than the Eudragide. So these are the commercial products mainly in the US market using the HPMC acetate succinate. Yeah, Mahesh, you can go to the next slide, please.
Yeah.
So these are the commercial products, the names, brand names, as well as the API names. What is available in the US market? Lendl was the first, developed by Xeria and Nissan Pharmaceuticals. That Incv, Calidico, Orkambi, Trikafta, Simdico, these are all from one company, Vertex. They mostly are by spray drying approach. And other side, like a Delstrigo, Fifeltro, Noxafil, these are from MSD. Noxafil is by hot melt extrusion, and Pifeltro and Delstrigo, I guess, is by spray drying approach. Down one, that is Zolgurav, I already spoke. And there's one interesting, is a veterinary product also using HPMC acetate succinate at the right hand side bottom corner, you can see. So this is the veterinary product which is using HPMC acetate succinate in solid dispersion. Go to the next slide, please, Mahesh.
Yeah,
so to summarize the introduction or HPMC acetate succinate part, it is a very effective method for solubility enhancement. Cellulose derivatives like HPMC acetate succinate, HPMC phthalate, HPMC are useful for solid dispersion carriers, but there is no thumb rule like, you know, directly where and which polymer you can use. So you need to take some trials to decide on which polymer works better for which kind of API. And among them, HPMC acetate succinate has excellent capabilities for maintaining supersaturation and amorphous form with good stability. So we have seen with an external article also, because of this reason, HPMC acetate succinate, there are around 11 products in the market used for the solid dispersion approach. So thank you very much. Thank you for your attention. If you have any questions,